16th of Sunstorm, a holiday celebrated all over Tamriel as Heart's Day. It seems that in every house, the legend of the lovers is being sung for the younger generation. In honor of these lovers, Polydor and Alosha, the inns of the town offer a free room for visitors. If such kindness had been given to the lovers, it is said, it would always be springtime in the world. Basically, giving them a free room. I see that we... A knight. I wonder why this guy decided to attack me. Okay. Grimfangs. I see. So they are falling upon their threat. Not that it matters to me, but yeah, it's sort of refreshing to be honest. Oh, there you are. And you're gonna do this right in front of the guard, huh? Using some footwork here. Let's see if this guy has like something else on him. Kill Grimfangs before too much is learned. Use any means. W. I'm guessing that stands for football. Because that's the only way it makes sense. Like, that's the only person who might want to attack me now that I know about the. Totem of Tiber Septim. Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. We are in front of the Knights Guild in Wayrest, and as you can see, it's already slow. It's 7:38 in the morning, so we're gonna have to loiter here for a while. Let's go ahead and head to that. But yeah, I have been getting attacked. I don't know whether I showed you that or not, but I have been getting attacked by random people. People after my life. And yeah, following the threat that I got. But yeah, today's objective is to go from commander to one. Rank up, essentially. yeah, let's get a quest. I'm too late, really? Well, I had work, but I hired the fighter skill to do it. Really? I wonder why that happened, twice now. Have I got a good one for you? It seems Mynisera sleep just read about an ancient family curse, now she's scared out of her mind. She wants someone to go destroy her great-great-great-grandmother, right? Whom she fears walks the earth as an undead monstrosity. Are you interested, Commander? Commander, I like the way he addresses me. Mynisera sleep's ancient ancestors entombed in a mausoleum named the Roost of Skulrathrac. Now, here's the thing, we've already been to the Roost of Skulrathrac. And I hope that will help us in navigating the area better. That was designed to prevent grave robbing. There's no proof she's even undead. Odds are she's just a corpse. If so, burn the body in a proper funeral pyre, get back within 24 days, or... Buckingsley says the curse triggered. Right, so we have done this quest before. This is the second time that we're doing this quest. And we have also visited the Roost of Skulrathrac previously. Before I go and do anything, let me just equip this shirt set. That will give me, instead of a charisma boost, a... I think it does something, I forgot exactly what it does. No. I do have some tights with me. Yeah, let me put this in my inventory as well. In case there are too many, you know, spellcasters, I'll just change into these tights. Tell them to wait for a second and change into these tights and cast silence on them. Another thing that I have been wondering is, where do I sell all this expensive stuff? I can't figure out where to sell them because this is like 1,000 gold, this is also like 1,000 gold, 2,500 gold, my bad. And yeah, that's not as expensive. 100 gold. So yeah, I've been wondering where I can sell all this stuff. Apparently there aren't many places where I can do that. Also, have I ever told you guys that I love this music, the background music, the winter background music? Right, the Roost of Skulrathrac. I don't recall which quest it was, but it was one of the quests that we had been to before. And of course, we'll be going by foot or horse. poppy feathers everywhere. I think this was one of the dungeons that we left out with last time. I think that is the entrance. Let's go there. Unless it wasn't, who knows? The dungeon's locked. Oh yeah, it's the same thing. So, the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go down this side and just check it out quickly. I think this was the right way to go, I'm not sure though. What are humans doing with our bees is something that I've always wondered. Let me take a poll, please. Thank you. Probably should not drop down there like that. So the last time the mummy was right here, I'm hoping it's the same again. Even if it is not, it is still one of the rope. Yeah, it's still one of the objective areas in the game, so 164 pieces. Wait. Yeah, I do have a lot of things on me, don't I? Like magic, when it comes to magical items. Some of them probably are weighing me down. So with that area out, that there are no, you know, enemies over there. Is this thing coming down? Well, I suppose not. Oh no, I got stuck. Can I rest here? No, of course not. There are enemies nearby. My only concern is that my health is running a little low at this point, so I don't exactly want to get into an ambush and lose my life. This is essentially the same dungeon that we got the first time around as well. There's even like a chair here, so for us to, you know, rest. Come on then. I'll just leave it here. Where's the enemy go? Wait. Yeah, there are two of these here. I wonder what the other one does. Well, I have no clue, to be honest. It did something. I'm just not certain what it did. So, where do you want to go? This was a little confounding of a dungeon. Hi there, rogue. I'm assuming you're a rogue. You sort of look like one, you know? Yeah, so we have already cleared out one of those sections which could possibly have had the quest target in it. The one section that we, you know, conveniently missed the first time around that we played this game. I don't exactly want to go into water, and mummies are never underwater, so we just keep that side B. I don't recall ever coming here, to be honest. Huh. We just leave that side B, because, well, like I said, mummies don't exactly live underwater. Did they change the layout, I wonder? Do I want to go here, or do I want to check this out first? Right. Let's go. I think this also ended up in a dead end of sorts. Are you like a vampire? Huh. not as powerful as I was expecting her to be. Priestess ropes, a priestess turned vampire. Okay, snake tongue. And this as well. Map. Okay, let's use that cross energy. Perfect. Finally drawn, Vellum reveals the secret location of the ruins of the old Hogford hovel, which you record. Essentially, as it turns out, in most cases, if you want to go dungeon crawling independently without the aid of quests, you will have to rely on these maps, because otherwise most of the dungeons that you get are, you know, essentially. So this is where it comes out. Yeah. Wait, no, this is a different place. Oh, okay. Hi there. Now, before I go ahead and start raiding this area, I wanna... Is that Ebony? Of course not, it's Iron. It would have been like a completely different game had it been Ebony. Dealing with that guy, I mean. So, yeah, before I go here, I wanna clear this area out first. I'm gonna drop this here. Hi there. I wonder why it was not a backstab, even though, I mean, I did sort of. I guess I swung at her back, I didn't stab her through the back, so. Yeah, semantics matter. Semantics matter. No, that is an elevator, I would suppose. Somebody opened the door for me. No mummy here either. Now that I've leveled up, this level is quite easy. Not as difficult anymore. I sort of feel like I'm moving slow, and I guess that's because I picked up those creeps, those stage creeps. The kind that I haven't worn in a few days. Ah, right, I forgot about these. The last time I came here, they were actually. I think this area leads nowhere. Yeah, it's like a dead end. Might as well mark that off the map. And. Right, over here. So, the last time we came here, this dungeon was infested with spiders. Why is this not open? Oh, right, that's the switch for the elevator, right. This is the switch for the other thing. I keep missing the turn. Another harpy. Not what I'm looking for, although I probably should have waited for her to say something. Try to defuse the situation without violence. Would you be attacking me? Seems you are. I mean, there's a chance that you can essentially use no violence and get away with it. A slipper of sorts. This house is nothing of value, so I can't enter it either, of course. That sounds like something interesting. Is that a mummy? If it is, then my quest is already over. No, that's just a vampire. I guess it must be because I've leveled up, but this, the experience in this dungeon is vastly different, especially the enemies. Stealth climbing, long raid. Now, the long raid, I want to level it up all the way to 87 because I need that to become, you know, a paladin in the Night of the Autumn. And medical is again something that I want to improve to 37. So, yeah. Let me just go ahead and save here. Is this something there? No, it's just like pillars, sort of supporting structures. Maybe they expanded here. So yeah, I can go down. I'm just wondering whether I should. I don't think I need to use that to go down anyway special either. So we came from there. Let's go ahead and check out the other side. There were two sides to this. Hi, vampire. I mean, I can understand why people like vampires, especially if they look like that. Lop is nothing to pick for me, of course it is not. Ah, yes, this lovely, lovely room. I've always been fascinated by this globe, to be honest. Let me just take a screenshot of this, and yeah. This is the thing going on Reddit about, you know, cozy Daggerfall ambiences, so I just wanted to take one for that. Daggerfall ambiences can indeed be very cozy. Any hidden doors? I mean, I'm certain there are enemies out there. It wouldn't be Daggerfall without enemies down there. And I guess the only option for us is to go into that, you know, entire cave system up top. I can hear a heartbeat. Hi there. Can I interest you in not attacking me then? Oh, it seems to have successful backstab. Nice. Wait, the harpy came to attack me, did it? Vampire just died. Now, I thought you were not going to attack me. I think, like, if you have your etiquette skill high enough, then you can even, like, not attack these vampires. Like, you don't have to engage them either. They will just ignore you for the most part. Until fully healed. A pretty open area to be just in. Okay, I'm guessing this is the... This is not a knight. Carolira Buckingston says, "Who were those barbarians? They almost killed you. Maybe you should have forgotten about Lysandus' ghost." Okay, Carolira Buckingston? Who is that? Or maybe that was that guy's dying message, I suppose. No, there is still one part that I want to check out. I just want to like cover all my bases, to be honest. Oh wait, okay, go ahead and loot this guy first. Yeah. That was like a strange message, I was not expecting that. And I don't know who that Carol, you know, button, whatever is. Yeah, let's use this. Yeah, pretty much. Adamantium mace. Let's keep this in our inventory then. Before I use that, I just wanna go ahead and check out that elevator up top. I think it's nothing special. I think it's something that we can just access as is without, you know, doing anything fancy. Button hopping. I think this would be the shortcut. If I'm not wrong. Wait, I think I missed it. Oh yeah, right here. So, what I want to do is essentially, let me save my user slot first. Grab mode. I just want to check out where this little goes, and I think it's somewhere we have already been before, but I'm just confirming. Yeah, it's pretty much the same case that we have been before, in fact. Wrong one. I still do want to correct that, because otherwise, let it be. Can I? Thank you. Long elevated rides. Right. Alright, let's make our way down there and take the elevator up to the cave system. Probably our target is probably somewhere there in the cave system. I recall this quest not being as difficult. I mean, section up there was difficult, more difficult than this part anyway. But I don't think it was too difficult. Just that we had to explore a lot before we finally got to the point. Let me save it here. It also had that one annoying... These guys have got like pretty sharp nails, don't they? I wonder how I can carry some of this stuff, because look at me, I mean, I've got... Does the orchestrated really weigh as much? So, the other sword that I have, the Ebony Saber of Oblivion, it is overpowered. Backstab and critical jump running has improved. I wonder if my medical skill will improve. Maybe I can just hit R and farm resting. So, something about the sword. It is nasty. Because, you see, it's enchanted with a spell called Sphere of Negation. And what Sphere of Negation does is, it does not matter how powerful the enemy is. If you cast Sphere of Negation on them, there's a certain chance that they can just obliterate. Like, literally get obliterated. And yeah, to me that's pretty cool, to be honest. I just want to go down here first. Let's keep this here. I mean, it doesn't matter how powerful they are, they will just die. Like, one hit and done. And if you recall me using... Oh, which was the... Deeper. If you recall me using the Daedric Sword, which is like the top tier element in this game, even that wasn't as powerful to be able to essentially just outright kill enemies with one blow. Even that took like 2 or 3 blows against the harpies. This sword, one hit and you're done. One hit is all it takes. Mommy, are you here? Apparently not. No hidden doors either, so I guess that's that. This area was a dead end. I'm just procedurally clearing out all of these, you know, dungeon modules, and one of the good things I would say about this, all of this, is that we have already explored it previously, so makes it much easier. So yeah, this is like a far superior weapon as compared to the rest of the weapons that I have. Look at that, one hit and the vampire is done. Save versus spell made. But the sword is still like causing damage because it is, after all, an ebony sword. So it's not like the sword isn't causing any damage, it still is causing damage. It's just that potion of a vampire with a potion of purification, what were you, suicidal? Huh. 1.5 kilograms, so yeah, I'll just... I guess I finally reached my limit, huh? So, yeah, even if the spell does not succeed, you're still causing damage to the enemies. Which is amazing, if you ask me. Yeah, nothing here, as expected. Since we were led here by the enemies, let's just go ahead and clear the side out. Now, the unicorn horn does say that it gives you like 200 gold, but given everything that I've experienced in shops this far, the best I'll fetch for it is like 50 gold or so. Mostly like 60 gold, realistically. will just like one hit and she's dead. That's all that's required. Like, completely overpowered weapon. So if you're ever playing like a spell sword, or you're taking up the ability to enchant weapons, I would highly recommend that you begin. Yeah, this one section was a little difficult for me personally. It's confusing more than it is difficult, but yeah, you don't really get as much rest with this section either. Now, there is somebody shooting arrows at me, so what I'll go ahead and do is change over to my bow and arrow. And yeah, this is something that I do want to upgrade as well. Right hand equipped. Now, where am I getting shot from is the question. Is that somebody over there? Is there somebody? Oh, right there. I see. Nice of you to join us, I guess. I don't know, did you drown and die? I mean, you certainly could not have survived that. Yeah, so essentially this is the part of the game which I found a little confusing. And one thing that I do not want to do for sure is go for a swim right now. So let's go ahead and re-equip the stuff. Wish I had a wagon right now. Not too bad, I can't exactly pull the wagon behind me inside of a damn dungeon, so. Let's go ahead and use a potion of meditation. We want to get all the way there. Meditation, right here. Another thing that sucks about this game sometimes is the fact that. Of course, I can't carry any more stuff, so I'm just wasting my time looking here. Yeah. Even if you have like potions of levitation, like once you use a potion, it won't let you. Like once you use a potion, you have to manually get back into like interact mode. It doesn't do that for you automatically. Hi there. I think there was only one here, and one another one in the next room. Ooh, dwarven. Okay. But unfortunately, I got like much better stuff on me. So I don't exactly need that. Now at this point I would appreciate a place where I can see rest, and yeah, I can rest here. I thought there was supposed to be another person there, but I guess not. Was there like a hidden door somewhere here? I heard something opening. What did I just hear? Ah, I see. There's like a... Up there. I see. And they're aware of me. I don't know how. Like, something that I always find... I've always found strange about these games is how curious and... assassins always knew how and where to find you. I can hear some vile things. Ah, maybe it was you that I could hear. These guys hit hard. These guys hit hard, I'm not gonna lie. Why do I keep checking? Why do I even bother checking the inventory? Hopefully I can rest now after this encounter here. Can't carry any more stuff. That's enough for the wound, of course. Stealth long blade is improved. How much is it now? 71%. Good. That's essentially what I was looking for. Yeah, let's switch back to the Saber of Oblivion. Let's save you. Because we just did everything, so. It's a pity that we can't pick up any more stuff. I would have liked to pick up some stuff. There was supposed to be an enemy here, I wonder what happened to that enemy. As expected, the section has nothing. I hear some sort of an orc. So this moves something. I don't exactly know what it moves. I think it moves the column that is supposed to be above us. It does something. I really don't know what it does. And going underwater in this section is more or less a waste because, well, you can bet that your enemies are not underwater, given the fact that it's supposed to be an undead mummy. Look at that. One hit and she's done. I'm just going to remove this. Okay, okay. I see. Let me drop this and remove this. 72 gold pieces. Cool. So, 1.5 kilograms apparently makes a lot of difference in this game. Like, 72 gold is not 1.5 kilograms. Which is something that that's mind-boggling to me. Personally. Excuse me. Reminder to edit that out. If I forget to, please, you know, do not crucify me or anything. Right, this minaret doesn't really have any fire to go. Before I go up higher, I want to check downstairs. Whatever is downstairs. Oh, it's just a bunch of water. No problem. Like, no need to go down there because. There's no water where we are going. So this is one area that I would like to check at the very end. But yeah. I would like to check that area out at the very end. But until then, let's go ahead and check these sides out. There was no that thing still there. I wonder what that. Lever does. Whether it even does anything or not. Ooh, this one knows how to fight. Fighting you was enjoyable, ma'am. Wayrest, let's go. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. I'm gonna equip this, of course. Ebony Wayrest, come on. Now, the moment I saw it, it looked all black and shiny, and ooh, I knew I lucked out. So, saving here. In celebration of the fact. Maybe we should rest this up. Gotta, you know, push our medical skill up. Hi there, Harpy. Right, so since we are here, might as well explore this area, I suppose. Oh, okay, it's one of the ways that we did not go here. Is there somewhere? Does this lead somewhere? I think we've already been here, right? We have already been here. And we never even saw this, you know, tiny little tunnel here. Let's put something here so that we can recognize that we have been here before. Now, I just need to remember the fact that. Did we come here? Oh, we have not. We have not come here yet. Either. No wonder the other person was so, you know, hot so brilliant. They had a literal ebony virus on. Now, all that's left are my boots. These are mithril boots and an elven left pauldron. Also, the creeps. This is, I think, even though it does not look like it, it is dwarven. So, yeah. I guess, or so I suppose. It just says helm, to be honest, with a plus 5 armor rating. I think that's Elven and not Dwarven. Yeah, I think we have also been that way. So, let's head back then. we have explored this area. This is essentially another exit out of this dungeon. We get go there last after we explore the top part over there. Hi there. You fell to the sphere of negation. Or rather, to the effects of the sphere of negation. It's crazy how, if you like remove 1.5 kilograms from your inventory, you can pick up so much gold. So much gold. Okay, why don't you come up here? I guess the guy second time around, these look like elven, no, just chain boots. Chain boots, they look pretty similar to elven boots, so it's easy to get confused by them. That's strange. From here it looks like a normal place, but when I come here it's... Yeah, nope, not going good. Underwater sections count me out. Because I do not think a mummy would be in an underwater section. At any rate, so... Yeah, count me out. Now that this area is cleared, let's go up this, yeah, that trap section over there. There's like this entire trap section over there, which is easy to miss if you're not paying attention, so log is nothing to fear for me. I wonder if the sphere of negation succeeds on the door, will it make the door disappear as well? Plus four, yeah. Tower shields cannot be upgraded in this game, sadly. Iron greaves, iron curses, I don't know why I'm even looking, because I already have an ebony. This looks like a hidden door. I guess not. The graphics are just wonky. I already have an ebony curse that I got this playthrough itself. Another lock that has nothing to fear from me. Open up, come on. So what we need to do is be careful. That guy's still unaware of me, which is strange to say at least. Hi there. Rogue is aside. That's a pretty nice sword, too bad I can't carry it with me. 96 gold pieces, I can... Oh, I got an upgrade with this as well. Yeah, let me remove that into his inventory and let me fear that. Equip it, yes. 17. Let's see here. Plus 6, yeah, so what I have on my head is an elven helm. Right. Anything here? There could have been a mummy here, but no, nothing here. And this right here is the trapdoor. You can see like the discolored edges along the tip of the sword that I'm trying to point out. So yeah, that's literally the trapdoor. You stand on it, you're gonna fall to the bottom. So be careful. Do not stand on that thing. I do not think this area has any more hidden doors or anything of that sort. So I guess we'll be checking this side out then. Let me just go ahead and check whether any of these areas have any hidden doors that we are missing out on. Does not seem to be the case, so let's go ahead and so I don't even need to be varying these sides, I can just use them for my inventory itself. still falling. I'm just looking for the potion of levitation here. Yes, right here. And moreover, I would like to use my salatites. I don't know what the vampire did, but whatever the vampire did, it was really damaging. Really damaging. What was that? So I have no idea what that vampire did, but it hit me again. Unless it was like an invisible enemy of some sort. I don't know what that was. My god, that was insane. Let me use like a potion of resist shock, I suppose. A potion of resist fire too. And a potion of levitation. And let me use the of silence, whatever that was. I think it was like a thousand of silence or something. I've got way too many of these potions, and sadly these potions do not stack at all. Undeniable access, fireballs, lightning, feather weight, shocking, silentites, right. Whoa, what is that? My medical skill is improved, yes, but what's going on with me? Like, why am I losing out on so much health? So it's like every single time I move, like, does it have something to do with... Hold up. Yeah, it does have something to do with moving. It's like every single time I move, it sort of takes away my health. Seems to be some sort of spell here, to be honest. Don't know whether it's like a the floor is lava thing or what, but well, let me just try sticking to sleeping around. So in here is fine, out there it's not fine. So there's something wrong with that place over there. So, no mummy here, but I do have like a ton of loot. There are enemies nearby. Now that is going to be a problem while getting out, to be honest. Anything of value here? Just gold and alchemical supplies. Cannot carry any more stuff. I'm still gonna check these out just in case. Cannot carry that. Yeah, this did not have anything of value. Enemies nearby. I just want to go ahead and try using another potion of levitation. Okay, right here. And I wanna move up a little so that I can. Walk out of here without taking any damage. Barbarian just died. Who? I can't sleep now? Now, what about now? Yeah, because I was in the air. trying to sleep while levitating. So, I think I have explored this area, but I could not find the target. I suppose what I could do instead is try going the other way. Unless there are a few more areas that I have not checked out yet. I don't know that is where we came from. We went up there to check things out. Check that side out as well. Underwater, there's nobody really going to be underwater. I do not think there's like a platform there. that I can go and check out? No, there is not. There's just water everywhere. I guess we'll start by going the other direction. But not this little alcove here. Yeah, since we came this way, let's try going the other way then. Right? Wait, was this the way we came from? Where's the way out then? I'm confused at this point, that this map has me turned around. I think the way out would be this way. That would be the way out, and yeah, we haven't been here yet. Let's drop this and proceed on our way then. Nope, we have already covered this area. Or so it would seem. I thought we came to a crossroads at some point. We have been here as well. Nothing ends in a little bit of nothing. We have covered that section as well. Is there any place that I'm leaving explored then? This side? No, we have been here. Curious. Like, was there supposed to be a body somewhere that I had to burn? Oh, there was supposed to be a mummy in any piece. In any event, there was always supposed to be a mummy. Unless one of these underwater areas takes me to, like, a dry patch of land somewhere. Unless the area that I'm thinking about is here? No, it's not. It's not really here. Let's see. Let's continue on. Okay, wait. So this is the area that we started out with. We have been there. We have covered this area. There's nothing more here to explore. Time to head back upstairs. And I do believe that is where we came out from. No? How did we get here? There was, like, some sort of passage that led here. I think this was it? Yeah, this was it. Or so I would suppose. I can hear harpies around me. Hold up, just go alone though. This is still not the way out. But I can hear lots of stuff back there. No. The issue is, there was supposed to be some sort of a... Oh wait, this is probably here. Here it is. The way back to the elevator, because I am assuming at this point that I have mostly covered everything in this area, including that one accursed place. And since we are hunting for a mummy, I do not see any sense in... Well... going elsewhere, but at the same time... Is there something that I'm missing then? because where would... Where else could the mummy be? We have already checked everything. Let me just go check out something here. We haven't found the mummy yet. I can still hear Harpy, is my primary concern. Like, in this area I can still hear the Harpy. What I would like to know is how is it that I can get to the damn thing. Because that seems to be the only place where I could possibly find a mummy. So for the sake of your own safety, don't jump off the way I did. It's gonna be hard on your knees. Did I perhaps miss something here? That is the only thing I can think of at this point. Because that area is a curse, there's no going there. And there is surely no benefit that will come of going underwater. That is essentially just a waste of time. Down there. Nothing over there. Soil, I suppose. There are entire like structures down there, but like I said, it's all underwater, so mummies aren't going to be underwater. And I did not find any generic first object looking dead bodies either, so something that I'm supposed to burn, so to speak. So I'm at this point a little confused about where to go. Unless where I need to go is basically back to the very beginning again. I just want to check something out. Here. To fear of those vampires over there. I don't think we have any. We can still hear some rats. I don't have all day. I swear I don't have all day. Come on then. Just in the nick of time. And nothing good is gonna come off going there. Enemies nearby, I hear that, but I cannot see any of these enemies that are supposed to be near me. Sometimes when I look at the gauge, it looks like I've got like spellcasting prowess, except I don't. Let's try going back downstairs. I suppose that's the only explanation that I can think of at this point in time. Maybe the person that we're looking for is in fact somewhere down there. Was there like a fork that I could have taken somewhere? No, right? Right. Sort of like a bug that when you touch, sorry, when you're riding an elevator or something and you essentially pause the game by doing something like pulling out your journal, it's gonna eat you. Like it's gonna suspend you in midair and then you resume, you're just gonna essentially fall down. Now, we did get that message some time ago about something that, you know, somebody said there was a barbarian in here, and it even had the letter on it, but I don't know if the game got confused or something, but because I can't seem to find the description at all. I mean, this is a way to get upstairs quickly. We have checked everywhere over there as well. I suppose the only thing left for us to do is try out this one then. This little elevator and see wherever it takes us. Which I'm pretty sure it will just take us down there, the place that we've already been before. Because there's literally nothing else to this map, except for perhaps this one area behind this section, which I don't know if there is even anything back there. The only reason that we assume there is because there's something extended behind this wall, but there isn't really a way to get there as far as I know. And I don't think there is any way for us to get up from anywhere down here either, like get up there. We can try going back down again. Honestly, I don't know how useful that is going to be, but what if there's something up there though? Let's go ahead and check, I suppose. I do hope that I have a potion of levitation left. Oh, multiple of them. So that's good. Let's go upstairs. Let's see what this area holds for us. If there is anything at all up here. I see something. I don't know how to get out of it. Ah, through the corner, I see. Okay. that rope died. So this is like another hidden corner of the map. And just look at how beautiful this looks. Too bad we don't exactly want to use it. Just gonna save the game here. The lock is not going to fear for me. It should. The lock should fear me. Okay, so there are two of these controls here. I don't know what they do, to be honest. Okay, they open this thing up, and I'm assuming that is a chain of slow falling. Which I personally dislike because... you know, this, I have no idea what it does. Unless it opens up that gate over there. Or calls an elevator up or something. Oh well. Let me see if indeed moves the slot before I go ahead and try touching this thing. Yep, slow fall. Yeah, I'm supposed to be falling, that's what I'm wondering. I'm supposed to be falling, but I'm not falling. It takes a while for you to fall. I just hope the spell doesn't disappear in the middle of it. Whoops! Looks like he fell too far. Yay! Hey! Wait for me. The harpy fell down? How is that possible? Harpy just died. Okay. We have all just been talking. I want to go back up and check if that opened up the wall to the other side. Because that's the only possible explanation that I can think of at this point about where else we have left to go. Because this dungeon module will be able to like explode one side, if it even has another side. Which I'm hoping it does, because otherwise we don't have a quest objective anywhere. Like, one of the things about exploring dungeons in this game is how you can literally hit rooms at the same dungeon and explore it multiple times before you keep learning something or the other that's, you know, new to you. This side over. That's interesting. So I'm guessing this side is now open? Is it? Oh no. So I'm guessing I'm gonna have to climb through the other side then? So now this side is blocked off. Okay, right. So let me hitch it right back down. And this is exciting. Now the other side has been unlocked. Let's hope that it actually does matter. The other side, I mean. So apparently if you want to switch sides, you need to unlock the mechanism from up there. And I wonder how long the other side is going to be now. You can't just get out from the same side anymore. Now what I want to do is I want to make sure that I'm facing the correct way. So that when I get up, I come out on either of these sides. So yeah, wish me luck. I'm gonna save it in this spot. Come on, climb, sir. Climb, come on. You can climb. Yeah, good shot. It's difficult to fail a climb, but it does happen. But although you can like occasionally slip off, but you will manage to like grab something before you get all the way down. Before you fall all the way down. So Nope, this side is still locked. But only difference is the other side is blocked off as well now. Now what do we do? The only option we have at this point is to go back up there and re-engage that damn thing. So you know what, let's just go ahead and go to the emergency slot. Because one of the things that I dislike doing is the same thing over and over again. I'm assuming this is what did it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a potion of levitation this time around. Levitate. I do hope that I have more potions of levitation, but in case I don't, well, it's sad. Don't really want to use slow falling anymore. This side is still locked, which is something that is strange to me. But what I will do is I'll use this machine as well, this mechanism, and see what happens to the other side. Nothing? Nothing happens. This side is still open. Does all it do is open up the trapdoor up top? No, wait. Something happened to it. These are still locked. I see. So is it, I'm guessing that's how far we go on that side. I guess though, this should be though. This should be a bit. Let me try something. This opens the trapdoor. I'm gonna switch this to off. And I'm gonna use like a potion of levitation. Just something else of levitation, you know. Are we on the other side now? Nope. Pretty much still on the same side. I'm assuming this is going to pull up these walls here. Yep. No, we can't go anywhere. Can't go anywhere at this point either. I'm thinking that the thing up top is now closed. This section should have been closed off. Oh, right. I made the same mistake again. There's somebody over here. Excuse me? We should be leaving this open, we should be jumping down from this point. Unless this looks like a door of sorts. Let's explore this area first. Hopefully it has something of value, which it of course does not. cloak increases invisibility. I guess I'll keep it. Four beds for two peoples. And I wonder how to get there. Levitation. This is still close, of course. But now a harpy comes here from somewhere, God knows where. Because here's the thing, this part is not blocked off. There's a wall here. And this like little root on the ground, which I know for certain that I did not keep. There's also this dead harpy here. So I can only assume that it all leads somewhere. But it does not. Interesting. I wonder if this would take me somewhere. No, it just takes me down to the very bottom of things. But where's the wall with the stair then? I'm on the other side now. I see. I'm on the other side now. So it does open things up, but not in the way you expect it to. Also, there's nothing here. Like, literally nothing of value here. And it even pulls up like another wall over here. So it essentially blocks off your only means of escape. Right, so this is practically useless. Should I? Might as well, right? What breathing. My god, this guy won't stop. Okay. This side perhaps? I can already see like a fatal creature in front of me. Actually, I want to move faster than this. Let's put in a popular potion of water walking as well. Thank you. Thank you for dying. What is that? My god. Excuse me. Please, I'm in a hurry. Can you please get a move on already? Thank you. Not what I was looking for. Ah. Wait, I wanted to pin it before. This takes me here, that takes me here. Okay. I do have another potion of water walking, so maybe that will come in handy. Water breathing at least. I do have like a potion of water breathing, I don't know about water walking anymore. The second? What the hell? These guys hit hard. Too bad I don't have any space. Ooh boy, that's a very slow and sluggish walk. Slow and sluggish runs the race, I guess. I think I could have probably made it out of here either way. So why did I come here again? Is it literally anything new? Except for, you know, these two pathways. Oh! There's the mummy! All the way over there, like literally just stuck on something. Come here. The mummies need to rest. When now Sir Buckingsley need not worry about that curse now. Right. Okay. Then let's hopefully make our way out of back out of here quickly. Yeah, I feel like this is not too long. I feel like I could take this journey without needing to rely on, you know. Yeah, without needing to rely on potions. Awesome. So, that was a bit of a surge, I'm not gonna lie, that was a bit of a surge. So, which way did we come from? Over here, yes. Back to the throne room with us, I suppose. I mean, of all the places where you could hide a mummy, I wasn't even going to the underwater areas because it would have been counterproductive. But then, you just have to, because sometimes the enemies are hiding right under your noses. I do not think this is the correct way. This should be the way without any, yeah, these gift boxes. Ah, yes, right here. Straight and narrow. We haven't been down there, have we? Nothing here. I mean, since we are roaming around, might as well check it out. Like, we have already explored most of this dungeon anyway. RP stealth, swimming and running. That's really good to know. Okay. Nothing here. Open up. Talk about an ambush. As soon as you open the door, these guys just ambush me out of nowhere. My god. Do you have anything important for me, is the question. Anything that I can use? Okay. Can you open it rather quickly, please? Oh, hey, no loot. 24 pieces of gold. If the game had lived up to its original design, people would have been able to loot these containers as well. Although you probably would not have been able to carry all of that loot. If only our equipment did not weigh us down as much, you know. Holy shite! That is a lot of people. Can I equip this? Okay. Lysosa coven, which is a witch's coven. I've actually heard that witch covens are. Why am I even bothering with that? I already have a data creeps. Yeah, so what I've heard is that witch covens are really good places. As in, they can be pretty beneficial places, is what I've heard. Let's see what's behind this door and hope that we won't die while trying to open it. If it opens in the first place, that is. I opened nothing here, just in an empty room. I'm guessing it's this is probably one of those other places where the first objective could be. So this one area somewhere we have never ever. Successful backstab, yay! So, yeah, I'm guessing this is one of the areas where we have never really come before. So, like one of the areas that I had neglected to come and check. So, I don't know whether I showed this or not, but that side, every time you essentially Flick the switch up there, it's just going to pull up this wall and it lowers that wall, and there's nothing over there except for just like continuation and a dead end. You've got one RP in there and a few other. Some piles of loot essentially. So I'm gonna go to the roost, just get out of here. Okay, Wayrest. Time to travel to Wayrest, of course. I think I'm getting about 7,000 pieces of gold right now. Stealth, long blade, jumping, and critical strike. I just want to quickly check on where my long blade is. It's at 72%. I mean, it's gonna be improving 1% at a time anyway. But yeah, I'm quite satisfied with how this all turned out. Don't see any enemies after me. I guess it's okay for me to sheath the sword. It doesn't take too long to draw it out anyway, so we should be good. We should be good. The horse plops, plops, plops underwater. Goes for a little swim of his own. Lodger for 5 hours. Good thing about loitering is, or the entire rest menu really, is the fact that it will let you know if there are enemies nearby. Alright then. Let me talk to you. LLB, I didn't figure the Vanosa Buckingsley's ancestor was really one of the Walking Dead. You may have saved the local people from much misery and suffering. Yes, I did, and it was one hell of an explorative adventure. I was expecting this, to be honest. Of course, it's like the first promotion I got was with two quests, and for the second one, I only had to do one quest, so I was hoping that that would be the case this time around as well. So I guess even though the dungeon crawling was a long one, it wasn't as bad. It could have been like worse. I could have had to go on another similar quest and spend 3 hours in a dungeon meticulously searching around. But anyway, I digress. For meritorious service and unswerving loyalty to the ideals of the Knights of the Rose, you have been awarded the title of Marshal within the Order. As a symbol of your fellow knights' estimation, we have elected to present you with a new piece of armor. Congratulations, Marshal Grimfangs. Now that honestly sounds good. Who are you? I don't think I've seen you before. Did somebody lose their parents? Anyway, let's a fine piece of armor has been added to my inventory. Now, mithril gauntlets, elven gauntlets. I do wanna equip these. And I'll be selling these off. Let's remove this to the inventory, and what else can we move to the inventory? This, of course, and this. Sorry, the wagon, I mean. And keep this back into our lives. Now my character's looking a little more refined, to be honest. If only the helmet looked better, but oh well. I mean, the helmets were designed very well in Daggerfall, in Arena rather. Not as well in these games. So anyway, that was that for today. The next time we come back, we'll be covering quests in that building over there until we hit the next rank. So until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things. Oh, and thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around to the end.